Because we live in a world prevailed by technology and various technological tools, why don't we use those tools in our advantage? In this video, we are going to learn how to build a frequency distribution table and a histogram using StatCrunch software and a graphing calculator. I'm going to use TI-84 graphing calculator, but if you have TI-83, it will work just as well.
First, look at how to use a StatCrunch software, which is a part of your subscription package of My MathLab Access, along with an ebook, access to assignments and help tools, publisher videos, PowerPoints, study guides. There are two ways to get to StatCrunch: directly from the website and our Canvas course page. To get to StatCrunch through your Canvas account, log in to our Canvas course page, click on My Lab and Mastering, then open My Lab and Mastering. It will open up to our course page. From the course page, click StatCrunch, then click StatCrunch website link. It will take you to the StatCrunch website. Click Open StatCrunch. When it opens up, it will look like Excel sheet, except StatCrunch has built-in statistics tools. You can type data yourself in the bars columns, or you can insert already prepared data sets. I'm going to type in the data that we used in a previous example of drive-through service times in seconds for McDonald's lunches.
Once you typed all the values in the bar 1 column, go to Start menu, choose Tables, choose Frequency, select our column with data, bar 1, leave Where and Group By optional. Since previously, we looked at three types of frequency distribution, regular, relative, and cumulative, I'm going to choose these three options. Order by ascending value from smallest to greatest, click Compute. Our table is done. The class width and the class limits were determined automatically by a program. In this case, the data set was divided into 6 classes with a class width of 50. Remember, a class width is found by the difference between 2 consecutive lower limits or 2 consecutive upper limits. Now we're going to construct a histogram. Since it is one of the types of graphs, it can be found under Graph menu. Click Graph, Histogram, select a column that has our data values, bar 1. There are 3 types of histograms: original frequency histogram, relative frequency built from relative frequency distribution, and density histogram. Choose frequency. Let's start our bins or bars at 75, like we did when we built it manually, with the class width of 50. If you would like mean and median to be displayed on your histogram, put check marks next to it. Leave dividers at none, click Compute. The histogram is ready. We can see that the shape of this histogram is the same as the shape of the histogram we built manually. See previous video with instructions. The distribution of this data set is slightly skewed to the right, probably because of a few outliers on the high end of this data set. As we predicted, the mean is located in the interval between 125 to 175 seconds. The mean is 168.24 seconds. And the median is pretty close too. Later, we will learn more about measures of center. But next, we'll learn how to use a graphing calculator.
It is always a good idea to know a few technological statistical tools to operate with data sets, especially with large data sets. If you are using the graphing calculator for your calculations, go to Stat, click Edit to enter the values in List 1. Type the data value, click Enter. Type the next data value, click Enter, and so on. When you enter all the data values in List 1, click Second, Stat Plot, press Enter to turn Plot 1 on, then Enter again to select On, choose Histogram, click Enter. Notice that your X list now says L1 or List 1, and frequency is 1, which means each value will be counted once. Go to Zoom, scroll down to 9, or just press 9, Zoom Stat. Here's your histogram. It looks slightly different than histogram that we built using StatCrunch. We can change that view by pressing the window, choosing our minimum value, 83, maximum value was 308, scale, which is our class size, is 50, minimum value on y-axis, we can choose 0, maximum value, let's choose 25, because remember our highest frequency was 24, so we go a little bit above, y scale 1, x 1, go back to graph, And here's the histogram that looks exactly like the one that we built manually. If you click Trace, you'll be able to see the minimum and the maximum in each class. Now you know how to build a histogram using StatCrunch and graphing calculator.